There are milestones along the way, and I came across one today. It's a big milestone, and maybe it's the granddaddy, it's the real big one. And that is, this morning, there was a realization that I was never born. I was never born, and it was a very strong realization. I couldn't get any sleep last night, so two nights in a row, no sleep. So this emerged, just I was never born. I said, yeah, that's true, I can see that. So now during the daytime moving around, of course it seems to recede a little bit, but it's very important to, we're going to pay attention to this here. I was never born, really, I was never born. And it's not only that, but it is, no one was ever born. Nothing's ever been born. This is even more powerful, it resonates more powerful. Nothing has ever been born. Yeah, this to me, that feels better. Wow. Immediately, the resonation, the ache is there. Wow, nothing has ever been born. So, I recommend in practicing, as you're practicing for yourself, try to shift it to everything. As I was saying, I was never born. No one's ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. That is absolutely true. Nothing has ever been born. So we are going to focus on this. Nothing has ever been born. And with all the practice we've done, understanding how to go about it, mood of repentance. I don't have a birth problem, I have a continuity problem. And the birth problem has no value to me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. So this is a big one. This is a very big milestone that needs to be. We need to really get into this. Because the notion, the false notion, that birth is possible is really causing us to remain extremely deluded. So we have to, what we're doing is we're accepting, getting to a level of acceptance of nothing's ever been born. We seem to think of birth as like some awesomely important, it has to take place, but we're shifting now, we're looking, nothing has ever been born. Birth is impossible. Birth is impossible. Now, I have great faith in this because I experienced it this morning. I saw I've never been born. And I saw why this is so. And my focus is not quite as clear right now. All the great teachers have said that. No one's ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. There's never been any birth whatsoever. No such thing exists. No such situation exists. Now our whole storyline, our whole path revolves around the belief that some birth has taken place and some beginning has taken place. There's no beginning in reality. There's no beginning, there's no ending, there's no path, there's no closer, there's no nearer. Birth is impossible. So all we're giving up is the notion that I was born, that anyone's been born, that anything's ever been born. It's a false notion, actually. And we're letting this sink in beneath the intellect. We're not holding this up to the intellect for the intellect to give its opinion. We're bypassing the opinion of the intellect. We already know what that is. Delay. Intellect's opinion is always delay. Always. What should we do about this? Well, I think we should delay on this one. That's all you're gonna ever get from the intellect. Oh, so there's no point in even engaging it at all. What we're dealing here with is facts. And this morning I saw it. It's a fact. It is a fact. And our spirit knows it's a fact. Our spirit knows nothing's ever born. Nothing's ever born. There is no birth. Nothing has ever been born. It doesn't exist. So what we're doing is we're getting comfortable with this. That's it. It's just getting our comfort zone, and so we can just recognize this. Realization. Recognize it. There's only one, just one. And how can one be born? There's only just one. Just one allness. There's nowhere for it to be born. It can't be born. It is all, always. But again, we're not trying to figure it out. We're trying to accept it. Accepting facts. I was never born. Now, we think the most important facet of quote-unquote our life is we were born. So we think of if we weren't born, we don't have any quote-unquote life. Well, we don't have a life story. We don't have a life path. We have a life. Absolutely. And it's not confined to any story or any path. You see, when we say we're born, we're confining ourselves to space, temporal matrix of body, perception, all this. Thinking that this is what we are, we've been born as this. No. What we are cannot be born. It's never been born. What kind of change can take place? What kind of birth can take place in pure spaciousness? Remember, all manifest and unmanifest are equally abiding in pure spaciousness right now. The totality is always within pure spaciousness right now. Now back to I was never born. This is a shocking, stunning recognition. And so we're not trying to figure it out too much here. What we're doing is we're preparing to see this and accept it, because it's right there. For me, it's barely beneath the surface here. It's starting to surface. This realization is starting to surface. I was never born. No one's ever been born. What a great realization, isn't it? Starting to see the positivity of that. Wow. So no one is their body. No one can be identified as a physical body, a physical form or anything. No one's ever been born. But I can feel we need to stay away from explanations on this one. The continuity fear is significant enough that it's easy to get tripped up by trying to figure it out and extrapolate upon it. This one is better to sit fairly silently with, I would say. So you need to evaluate when you're working with a declaration of fact, how to deal with it. Silence is usually the best way. And just let this ache set in. Just, I was never born. Nothing has ever been born. No one's ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. So what we're doing is we're holding this statement of declaration as fact in our mind, and we're letting our system adjust to it. This is a fact. This is the truth. Before, we were not holding the truth in our mind. Now we're holding the truth in our mind, and so we need to reorient to that truth. So we're just holding this truth in our mind. I was never born. No one has ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. There's never been anything born. There's never been any birth whatsoever. There's no such thing as birth. No such thing as being born. No such actual situation as being born. And again, we keep it out of the mind. The mind will object, of course. Our conditioning will object. We're not even entertaining the objection. So it's very important something this important, we do not entertain objections. We remain silent. Birth is impossible. Okay, birth is impossible. In reality, birth is impossible. I was never born. Now the mind is saying, can you explain this to me? Don't go there, don't go there. Because then you would have to explain, well, why did we imagine that we could be born, you see? And then you go off onto all sorts of mental, we don't want that. We what we're doing is we're adjusting, we want to adjust to the shock of realization. Precondition ourselves for the shock of realizing I was never born. I was never born. No thing has ever been born. I was never born. We view, the narrative is that being born is a super important step to take towards what? Towards some sort of transcendence of reality. Okay, so we're believing that we've been born because we think it's an all-important step towards being greater than God. So of course, realizing that we've never been born is an immense recognition. It's the crucial recognition. So this happened to me this morning, and I'm following up on it now, because it was not fully conscious. You know, it's right there, just beneath the surface, or just barely surfacing actually. I look at it as like a submarine. If you want imagery, a submarine with its the part that goes up, that where the hatch is and the periscope is, periscope chimney, the chimney of a submarine, it's just coming up above the surface, okay? And you're looking and you can see it. And the message that this submarine is delivering is, I was never born. Now, again, this is so crucial because we believe that in order to be greater than God, to find some hidden realm which is beyond the reach of God, and therefore to know more than God, we'll know both reality and the hidden realm, it's absolutely crucial to believe that birth is possible. Because birth means going from one realm into another, so to speak, or entering into an unknown realm where you previously were not there, But look at it this way. In the allness of oneness of pure spaciousness, zero dimensionality, we're always there. There's no way to enter into some other place where we haven't haven't previously been. We're in the oneness of pure spaciousness. There's only that. So it's impossible to be born into anything that's the slightest bit different at all. So the notion of birth is a meaningless concept. There's nothing that can be born. Now recognizing this is it's the end of the story of we're on some path towards some realm, some other realm. So our practice is designed for allowing these great recognitions to arise. This is the whole point of it. This is the discipline. The better, more skillful we become at this practice, mood of repentance, continuity, problem, practice, centering, do not translate anything into action, commitment to stillness, to non-action. Do not try to run with any insight that arises. Just remain steady, poised in present moment with what's, and allow this ache, this strain, this inner reverberation, just allow it to be there. And then these insights will rise as if a submarine rising from under the ocean. Now, of course, it's startling, it's stunning, it's shocking. You don't hear many people saying, I was never born. Nothing's ever been born. You don't hear that very often. So it's a very surprising to hear this, to focus on this. And we're focusing on it as an experience, not as an intellectual concept. And we are willing to be virtually floored by it, you know, but we're staying poised like this, sitting quietly. But we are willing to go through any ordeal to allow this recognition to arise. It's that important. And we're willing to give it time. Because it is so incredibly crucial. Nothing has ever been born. The intellect says, oh, I can help out with the strain. Just run it by me. Let me comment on this. No. No comments from the intellect. Because the feeling here, we know this is true. We know this is true. And the ache is there, just like, wow, all this time, all this foolishness of pretending that I was born. Pretending that everyone's been born. This is the great pretense here. What we are cannot be born. Where can the one go to be born? What can the one be born as, you see? What can everywhereness, how can you talk about everywhereness being born? Nothing has ever been born. So, obviously, with this recognition, there's going to be a shift in some sort of shift. We don't need to know exactly what it is, but obviously but we don't get ahead of ourselves. We just stick with this insight, this statement of fact, this declaration, actually a declaration. I was never born. I've never been born. I have never been born. No one has ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. Birth has never happened. keep the, again, the intellect out of it, comments to a minimum. We state it as fact, with assurance, adamant assurance, I was never born. I was never born. And we don't intellectualize it again. We don't start saying, well, what is I? What do you mean by this? What do you mean with me? What's the meaning? Now, the meaning is self-evident. I was never born. It's self-evident to spirit. We're talking, spirit's talking to itself right now. It's what spirit is doing is reassuring itself as it comes out of its hallucination of layers and levels. I was never born. It's like saying there's this pit. We think there's this pit. There's never been a pit. I've never been in the pit. There's never been some identity in a pit because there is no pit. How could there be identity in a pit when there is no pit? See, we think we're born into something, into layers and levels, that we're now here in this layers and levels. There are no layers and levels. So how can we be born into what doesn't exist? It's impossible, isn't it? It is absolutely impossible. So spirit is simply reminding itself, I was never born. I was never born. Obviously, once we recognize there is no pit, then it follows that we could never have been born into any such pit, right? It can't be. So this is part of waking up, part of realization is realizing I was never born. Of course, such a statement brings about a certain amount of consternation, okay? Absolutely. You see, part of the trouble on the path is the ego tells us it's supposed to be, we're not supposed to have any trouble. If we have trouble, so the ego says, well, it can't possibly be right then. Overlooking the continuity fear 100%, right? The ego always overlooks the continuity fear or underplays it. What we're saying here is, no, we have a very severe problem. The continuity problem is our only problem. But it's very severe. And, of course, when we say that I've never been born, this is going to bring about a sense of consternation within. There's also a feeling of relief. You can feel tinges of relief. But also turmoil and consternation, shock, continuity, concerns of, whoa, if I was never born, where am I? You know, and things like this. So all of this is going to be at play. And when you understand you do have a very severe continuity problem, you're patient with this, you're accepting of it. You don't dismiss it. You don't immediately flee to the intellect. Say, hey, intellect, can you straighten this out? I shouldn't be having this consternation. I'm a very very smart, bright person, you know? I shouldn't be experiencing this. No, that's where we go off the rails. So all practice is done in this mood of repentance, of humility, 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 humility. Confession of a continuity problem. Once you put you're grounded in humility and continuity confession, which is the mood of repentance, then when this consternation arises, you're not surprised by it at all. and you just sit quietly with it. With kindness and compassion and forgiveness and, you know, gentleness, you're willing to just sit there with it. And not try to force it to go away. Not turning to the intellect. Hey, intellect, can you help me straighten this out? No. There's going to be consternation. I was never born. There's going to be consternation. There's going to be a certain amount of upset, trepidation, just general consternation. What we do is we don't turn that into any emotion, any particular emotion. The intellect will try to identify something for us, label, identify. We're not interested in any labels, any identification, just a general sense of consternation. The ache, the burn, as I call it, the ache, the burn, the consternation. And we just know that there's a huge shakeup, all right? You know, I was never born. That is a gigantic shakeup in the whole structure of whatever structure there is. Doesn't matter what we call it. It's just bound to be a huge shakeup, right? So we let the shakeup happen. Just let it happen. To say, okay, I'm here. However long it takes, I'm just here. I'm just letting this shakeup happen. I was never born. I was never born. We don't expect some quick realization, some quick clarity. We expect that the consternation is going to do its thing, and we don't really need to label it, follow it like a storyline reporting on. No, it's just general sense of consternation at play. Just let it be at play. We just continue to assert, I was never born. Nothing has ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. When we're doing the right declarations in the mood of repentance, it doesn't take too many repetitions of it to hit home. Sometimes it's almost immediate, just wow, okay. So a lot of the time is spent in silence. We can either chew on it with our intellect or sit in silence and allow the consternation to sort itself out and to realign. Realign, there's a huge shakeup and realignment with this new, you know, perspective. I'm saying, I was never born. I was never born. No one has ever been born. And the shakeup is beyond the intellect. It is total. It is total. This reaches the totality of belief here, okay? Which is extensive. The intellect, they're like some announcers announcing a game or something. But the game is so much more to it than just the announcers announcing it and discussing it. This is altering the game itself, as it were. Saying the game's over. The game's over. It never started. My life never started. Life never started. Life never started. I was never born. Nothing has ever been born. Now, with anything this heavy, don't try to generalize it right away. If you feel when you're trying to generalize it, you're losing it, stop. Stop. Like if you try to say, this light was never born, this table was never born. When I start doing that right now, it brings the intellect into it too much. So don't bring the intellect into it. If you can generalize it, fine. But keep a close watch that it's not drifting off the track here. No one has ever been born. None of the one family, no one in the one family has ever been born. No one in the one family has ever been born. So, oftentimes, it's very important to not get too fancy here. Keep it very basic, very simple. Okay, very basic, very simple. Don't pressure yourself too much. This is enough. This declaration in itself is an enormous extrapolate too far ahead. It's just not in the past, not in the future, not parallel. It's just stay with the turmoil, as it were. Don't leave it. Keep reassuring yourself. You're right here, right here, right here. You're attentive to the turmoil as far as recognizing that's what's going on. But that's as much as you need to be attentive to. Just recognizing that this is a strain. This is turmoil, this is a strain. Don't be thinking about how you're gonna be when you realize that you're never born. No, stay with the turmoil. Don't make it more, don't make it less, don't try to do anything to it. Just acknowledge it. fine. Don't put any pressure on me. What are we going to do with this? No. See, that's a mistake. It's like a tremendous earthquake has happened within your psyche, within your awareness. Tremendous earthquake, and we just have faith that when it all settles out, it'll be a changed landscape, but a much better one for sure. So this is a landscape changer. See, we're not fooling around here. This is serious business here. I was never born. I was never born. No one has ever been born. Nothing's ever been born. This is a landscape changer. Not in a race to see how fast we can settle the turmoil down. Not at all. Nor how long we can prolong it. It's just... But we keep insisting, I was never born. I was never born. We may say, okay, I got it. Let me do something else now. No, we don't got it. This is, that's why it's important to start out in the morning with the declarations and spend time in the morning and kick the day off that way. And realize that, it's going to be an all-day ordeal for sure. All-day ordeal. It's like you're going to work. You're working on this today. Never born, yes, this is true. I was never born, yes, this is true. Something came flying down. Okay. I see. Wow. The most important understanding there is to understand that I was never born. This is absolutely fundamental. So we can say this, the most important fact that I need to know is that I was never born. Absolutely crucial. You get this fact wrong, everything else is going to be wrong. So, with great determination, I was never born. This is the essential first fact I must know about myself, is that I was never born. I must recognize and accept this fact of my essential fact of myself. I was never born. No one has ever been born. Nothing ever gets born. Now, by all means, when you're doing this, make an effort. Keep the burn going. Keep the burn going. Keep stoking the fire. Evaporate more and more and more of your continuity concern. Do it as long as you possibly can. But don't, in the interest of brevity, try to force things and say, well, I've got to stop soon, so I just got to really try to force this through. Don't do that. See, that's a problem. Now, of course, our attention will wander a little bit. That doesn't mean that we're finished. Just bring it back, bring it back. I was never born. The most essential fact of my being is that I was never born. The ego is saying, the intellect is saying, hey, you need to do this, you need to do this, you need to do this. I say, I can do it later. Not going to stop the momentum. Another way to say it is, the fact is, I was never born. 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 bird just showed up here, hopping around. Make sure your mind does not stray to some other locale. Past, present, future. Do not let it stray. Stay, keep it right on the here and now situation of the turmoil. Consternation. Now that means all these previous lives I've had, was I ever born then too? No, I was never born then either. I've never been born. I have never been born. Now, since you know this is true, you know it's a fact, spiritually you know it's a fact, so there can't possibly be any objections to it. So why even entertain them? See, that's the question. Why even entertain them? Is it just a delay? Is it continuity fear delay? I've never been born. No one has ever been born. This is a fact. This is the fundamental fact of truth of myself, that I have never been born. This is the fundamental statement of fact of the truth of myself, and that is I have never been born. I have never, ever been born. Absolute fact of my truth, essential fact of my truth, of my identity, is that I have never been born. I have never been born. We try to use bodies as proof that you've been born. It's just manufactured false evidence. Bodies are manufactured false evidence to try and tell us, hey, you've been born, see? What I am has never been born. I am has never been born. The essential fact of my identity is that what I am has never been born. What I am has never been born. What I am has never been born. So this is just like the first phase of working on this. First phase of working on this and just getting our feet wet. We will return to this absolute, all-important fact of our being, what I am, has never, ever been born. Never been born. This is just our first attempt. Okay, very great. I'll be back. That's it for this one.